Let me show you how to set up your Jotform chatbot agent here on a WordPress website. So let's get started. Hey, what's up everyone? My name is George, and on this video, I'm going to show you how to completely set up your Jotform chatbot agent on a WordPress site. So let's get started. So we're going to jump into my WordPress site, and I already have installed the WordPress plugin here on my website. If you don't know how to install this, there's a video on how to install the WordPress plugin. Okay, so let's get started. Once you have the plugin available here, there's a menu on the left that says Jotform AI Chatbot, and we are going to select it. So we're going to get started. And the first thing we need to do is allow Jotform to connect to the actual Jotform website. Remember, we are located in the WordPress website. So let's go ahead and allow. And be aware that if we are not logged in, it will prompt you to log in first in order to allow. Now we have two options to get started with the chatbot agent. We can go ahead and describe our agent right here, or we can select an agent that we previously created on the Jotform website. In this case, we want to do it straight from here. Okay, so we're going to describe our agent, and I do recommend that you give it a great description because it's going to give you better output on how the chatbot is going to perform, and it's going to save you time tweaking later on. So give it a good description here. In this case, I am going to use one of their examples, and I'm going to use the registration. So here's a demo description of a chatbot agent, and we're going to use this to start creating it. And this should take a few seconds for it to create. It's going to do its AI magic, and we're going to have a chatbot ready to start customizing. So let's wait a few seconds. All right, here we go. We are going to get started with the first steps. So we need to select the AI agent that's going to represent our chatbot. So in this case, I am going to select, her. Okay, so here we go. I'm going to select her, and her default agent name is Lila, but you don't have to stick with that. You can go ahead and change it. So I'm going to say that her name is Stephanie. So I'm just going to change it a bit. Here we go. And the agent role for this, she is a course registration assistant. So I highly recommend that you give it a good description for the agent job title, because this job title will also let it know how it's going to behave and what the job is for this agent. Now, this is aside from the knowledge base, but it gives it a description of how it has to behave. So this one is a course registration assistant. If you want to give it a better description for the job title, I do recommend that you add it here, okay? We're gonna stick with that one for this demo purpose. Then we have the default language. In this case, it's English, but we have all these available languages that you can select. Now, these are the languages available as of this video. There will be more in the future, okay? The tone of voice, we have the option for casual, professional, and friendly. In this case, I want to keep Stephanie friendly, so we're going to keep it like that, okay? Then we have the greeting message. You can enable or disable the greeting message if you like. So greeting message will kick off with that message that it has here, which is, hi, how can I assist you? You can go ahead and modify this, or you can just go ahead and turn it off if you don't want to provide a greeting message. But in this case, we want to keep it on, right? Then we have the chattiness, and it's going to be an option from minimal to chatty. Minimal would be like only what is required. It's just simple responses, quick and go, which could be good or bad depending on the amount of detail that you want to provide. Short or long would be the sweet spot, in my opinion. But you have the option to be chatty. So if you want to provide a lot of information, or you want it to be really super friendly and chatty, go ahead and select this one. I'm going to keep it in short for this purpose. Then we have the chat guidelines. Again, this is going to help it understand how it's going to be guided in this case. That's why it's a chat guide. So we can go ahead and add more guides here, aside from the ones that were created automatically with our description. So just go ahead and click on add and add the chat guide right here that you want to add here. So in case you want to add something else, if you're good to go with that, let's go ahead and continue with the agent style. Now here we are changing the style of the actual look of the chat bubble here, the chat system. So there's color schemes available that we can select. So if I want greenish, or we want this pinkish brown, just go ahead and select it. In this case, I'm going to use the green scheme here. So here we go, goes with Stephanie in this case. And here we go, we can go ahead and change the colors too. So the start and color, you don't have to stick with the color scheme. You have the chat style, chat background color. So maybe you don't want that mint color. Maybe we want to keep it white, just go ahead and select it, and it'll automatically change to white. So we have options to change here, okay? We can change the font family. There's available fonts here, chat theme color, and the button style. So there's like this purplish or pinkish kind of color here. We can go ahead and change that if it doesn't go with our branding and the icon color. In this case, we're good to go. Let's go into the next tab, which is visibility, all right? Then we have the layout. We can keep it minimal or we can keep it extended. Now in extended, it can kick off this way where it has more information and some buttons that we can click to get started. So it's a secondary option. In this case, I'm gonna keep it minimal. Then we have the position. In this case, I'm gonna send it to the left, and then we have pulsating. Do you want it to pulse? You can see right now that it's pulsing, and it kind of guides the viewer to look at the icon because it's pulsing. But if you think it's annoying, if you don't want that for your website, just go ahead and turn it off and there's no pulsing. In this case, I'm gonna keep it on because I do like it. Open by default, do you want it to open automatically or not? Or do you want it to open after X amount of seconds? In my personal opinion, I like the 10 seconds, but it's up to you if you just don't want to open it or if you want to open it from the beginning. It gives it time to someone to view the site, and if they are interested in what you have on the site, then it's going to pop up in 10 seconds. So it gives it a few seconds to open up, right? Then we have the visibility on devices. So do you want to open it on all devices, just on mobile or just on desktop? In this case, maybe we don't want to display it on the mobile phone. Maybe it's in the way. Maybe it's just already too much information on the website to have this chat bubble in the mobile view. You can just go ahead and select desktop and it'll pop up there, right? Then we have the advanced visibility options. We can show it on certain pages or we can hide it on certain pages. So if the URL is a certain link, we can go ahead and hide it. In this case, I am not going to add any option here, but you have options to add pages or URL. So pages would be easier if you want to hide on, so you don't have to add a link here. So, I mean, if you just want to hide it on certain pages, like checkout, here we go, which would not be a good option. Maybe in my account, you can go ahead and add it here and we're good to go. And you can go ahead and add more if you need to, right? Now let's go ahead and jump into the knowledge base. In knowledge base, it's super important that you add details here. Now, automatically, it grabbed information from the WordPress site that it's on. So it read the website to have it feed on the knowledge base. So if you have products, if you have blog posts, etc., it's gonna read that information, the privacy policy, etc., right? But we can add more knowledge to this, and there's several options available for this. We can add text-based knowledge. That means that if I know what people are going to ask, I can go ahead and type in here responses, and it'll have it ready in the chatbot. I also have the option to upload documents. So if I have a PDF, a text, or some other type of documents, I can go ahead and add them here and it'll automatically read them to have them ready to respond to certain questions that they might ask Stephanie in this case. A crawl URL. So if there's a specific link that you want to add here to crawl and grab that information, that is possible too. So let's just say that you want to sell products and you don't have it listed on your website, but you want that information, go ahead and crawl the website link of that product. And the last option is questions and answers. So if you already know what people are going to ask and you know the response to it, go ahead and provide it in advance here on the knowledge base. That means that if you know that they're gonna ask, what time do you close on Christmas or New Year or et cetera, or any holiday? Well, we don't open those days, but you can chat with me 24/7. I don't know, give it the response. And you can add here manually questions and answers. So there's several ways that you can feed the knowledge base to make your chatbot agent super smart. So once you are good to go ahead and preview this chatbot to make sure that it's working correctly and you're sure you like what you've just created. And here we go. We got Stephanie here. Here we got the welcome message, and in 10 seconds, it should open up. So we're not going to wait. We are going to go ahead and open up manually, and we're good to go to start chatting with Stephanie. And she's going to initialize the conversation. We continue here, chat with her, and we are good to go. So preview is fine. We know it's working. We can go ahead and publish this now, and we are good to go. Now, one of the cool features that Jotform plugin has now is that we can now view the conversations. So if we have a conversation with Stephanie, in this case, clients, visitors, fans, etc., we'll be able to view those conversations here on the conversations options on the left. So I am going to select it, and it's going to open up the conversations here. So remember, I just clicked on the link here and I clicked on the register for course. So it kicked off a conversation, and that's why I have the conversation here. And I'll be able to view all the conversations available right from my WordPress site without having to jump into the Jotform website, which saves me time. And then we have the settings options here on the plugin, which lets you log out in case you don't want to use the chatbot agent here anymore. And there's a WooCommerce option available too. This will require your REST API key. To grab that, you need to go to WooCommerce Settings, Advanced, and REST API. So let me go ahead and open this up in a new tab. Let's go to Settings. Here we go. We are now in the WooCommerce Settings section. We're going to go into Advanced. We're going to go to REST API. Let's create an API key. Here we go. Let's go ahead and give this description. I'm just going to say Jot or Jotform. And it's going to be for this user, permission, read and write. We're going to create the API key. And we now have a consumer key and a consumer secret. Be aware, do not share these details with anyone except your developer or people that you trust, because they will have access to the WooCommerce section. Now let's go ahead and connect to the WooCommerce section. Here we go. We are now connected. We have connected our store with the WordPress plugin, which is going to exponentially give it way more knowledge and way more power to the chatbot agent from Jotform. Okay. So chatbot availability. So we have the find products. It can find products straight from the chatbot. We can recommend products. We can add products to cart, show order status, and manage refunds is going to come soon. So in this case, if you don't want it to add products to cart, you can go ahead and turn this off, but we can find products and we can recommend products. So it's up to you what you want to enable or disable for the agent in terms of the WooCommerce feature. So you can see how easy that was to connect here on your WordPress plugin. So that is the AI agent from Jotform WordPress plugin that is super easy to set up here. So please let me know here in the comments what you would like to see in the future in terms of features and capabilities. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that little bell notification to get notified when new videos come out. And that is a wrap.